Christine D.
Judy M., how it goes?
Have you heard the news about this year's holiday show?
No.
You know, this COVID thing.
Yeah.
We're still social distancing, but want to do what safety allows.
How?
We're going to shoot it live and show it later.
Well, that's a whole lot of work.
But we should give it a try.
Yeah. What story will you have your players do?
I thought it might be fun if we all played some Clue.
Really?
Mystery. With Grove Spots.
Ha ha!
We'll give you clues in the show, but I don't want to ruin the plot.
How exactly would you capture all of this?
Well, we turn Town Hall into our forest.
We're on!
I'm sorry, but we gotta go.
But...
Cue the music, cue the chorus.
Our main characters, some Grove kids, start to play a game that is not what it appears.
Weird.
They realize they're trapped in this mystery that takes place somewhere very near.
Here.
They roam the grove seeking clues that lead them from one place to the next.
They'll get help from a few strange confidants.
They'll meet residents along the way who have lots to say. But what will be the denouement?
Well, let's see who's in the grove when it happens. The grove when it happens. The grove when it happens. Everyone is in the grove when it happens. The grove when it happens. The grove when it happens. Do our heroes know how the game is played? What the clues will relate? Who they should interrogate? We don't yet know what will happen. But let's find out who's in the grove when it happens. My God, in Grove we trust, but for all the players here, it's win or bust. Grove Clue made it happen. But who else was in the Grove when it happened?
Director Judy, tell us, please.
How can we do the show a whole nother year without all being together?
Director Judy, tell us, please.
Sometimes it feels like we're all doomed to be doing social distancing forever.
Director Judy, tell us, please.
Or did you realize that no matter how we do it, we can put on a great show?
Because we're from the Grove, we cannot be stopped.
You pulled us all together.
And I'm loving what we got. We got talent for days, so we found a new way. But you don't mess with me or the Grove Holiday Play. Oh, you'll get laughs from us, you'll get songs from us, but you'll have regrets if you don't join us.
You to be in the room when this happens, the room when this happens. Soon we'll all be in the room when this happens, the room where this happens. But until we're all in the room where this happens, the room where this happens, away.
This game sure looks old. Where did it come from?
Grandma's attic.
Oh, I remember playing this game as a kid. The first thing we need to do is pick our characters. Okay. I'll be Mr. Green.
There's no pink one, so I'll take the red one. I'm Miss Scarlet.
I'll be Colonel Mustard.
Mrs. Peacock here. Hey, look at the rules. It says, any questions regarding the rules of Clue will be answered gladly if a 3-cent stamp is included.
3 cents? A stamp? Why not just send a chat?
Well, so the goal of the game is to find out who the murderer was, what room the murder took place in, and what weapon was used.
Murder? Someone died?
There's a gun in this game?
Wow, look at that. Can I be Professor Plum?
Sure.
We have this game in France too. It's called Cluedo. We have La Cuisine, La Salle à Manger, Le Conservatoire.
Oh, and just what was the result of that? Marcel Marceau committing a murder in a cafe with a baguette? I just found Cluedo, the chocolate edition. Instead of cards, there are wrapped chocolates, and the winner divides the chocolates, and then the whole game gets eaten.
Now you're talking.
Yum.
Sounds good.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe you guys are playing a board game. How retro. There's not even a screen.
You can be Mrs. White.
Oh. Well, even if you are going to play Clue, you should at least play the new version. They replaced Mrs. White with Dr. Orchid, who is a biologist with a PhD in plant toxicology. Oh my.
Here's some new rules for our Clue game. It says, any questions regarding the rules of Grove Clue will be answered gladly. Just tweet us or go to our Facebook page.
See, I didn't press that 3-something.
In this game, no one is murdered. No one dies.
Well, of course no one gets murdered. It's a Grove game. It has to be family friendly.
There are only clues and riddles. You roll the dice, then go from there.
Well, that sounds very mysterious. A little difficult, maybe. Should we split into teams?
Sure. Yep.
Great idea. How about let's do rock, paper, scissors to decide. Ready? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
First, we're going to mess it in here. Clue number one. Through a wicket, not thicket, your fate will be sealed. This riddle should take you not so far afield. Hey, did anybody proofread this? There's a stray comma in here.
I think that's part of the clue.
Okay. Our turn.
Okay. Our turn. Let's see. Riddle number two. Some Grovians with no address are the ones that know the Grove the best. Roll the dice. Let's get moving. If we get grovered, it's going to take us 45 minutes to get anywhere.
I think the proper phrase is get groved. Oh. And look out.
Oops. I haven't seen you since the Labor Day game.
Or was it the 4th of July?
Hi.
Hey. How was summer in the park this year? Yeah. Did you get to spend much time away?
I heard you were all helping out with the women's club projects. What's the latest?
Quick, let's use this secret passageway.
Where did they go? I don't know. But look who's here. It's Eddie Viscosity in a turbulent car.
How about you? Can
Guess what? I've got some good news. I was able to hire some real-life detectives. They're from Philly, but they're down here investigating some suspicious activity in Durwood, and they have a little extra time for us.
You hired detectives? Where did you find the money?
Fruitcake sales, of course. Foundations are being shorn up all over the Grove.
Are these guys the detectives?
I'm delighted to meet you. Yes, things are definitely heating up over in Durwood, but we have time to help you out here with your situation. I am Inspector Clue, and these are my assistants, Captain Clueless and Captain Obvious. Wait. Are you Obvious?
I'm Clueless.
But I thought you were Obvious.
Obviously.
Well, seriously, aren't you Obvious?
Obviously, I am Clueless.
Well, you definitely are Clueless. But I thought that was Clueless.
Obviously, she is Clueless.
Ah, well then, obviously, you must be Captain Obvious.
Obviously.
Right. Okay, well, now that we have that all straightened out, let's get on with this murder investigation. We need to solve for you 3 facts. Who did it? Where did it? And with what weapon?
It's not a murder.
It's a quest.
Look at these arrows. They will lead us to our murder.
Inspector, these are not arrows.
These are wickets and thickets that led us to the field.
This can be a clue. This could too.
Obviously, they're playing croquet.
Aha! There's your murderer right there. Clearly, he is guilty. And with ballots up for what?
Inspector, again, they're just playing croquet.
They play Fridays when the weather is nice.
Anyone can play.
Anyone?
And the Labor Day sign here? It's not a clue. It's a leftover from last year's Labor Day.
I like it best when someone gets splattered.
And Inspector, these are not murder mysteries. It's a quest.
Wait, what's this?
Looks like maybe another riddle. It sounds like cold, but tastes so warm, and goes the best with bread of corn.
I guess where we are going here. Anyone hungry for chili?
So our clue said, some Grovians with no address are the ones that know the Grove the best. Now, I know that the post office doesn't think we have a real address, but some of us do.
Not all of us. Hey, follow that squirrel. All right, you guys, we know you have a clue for us, and we're not leaving until we get it.
Clue? What clue? I don't know anything about clue. I'm just here looking for my acorns as usual. What, are you saying my acorn is a clue? Stop harassing me! Clue? What clue? You know I like to take my walks at night. When would I have seen such a clue? You ought to be asking Rabbit. Rabbit looks so tasty. Guilty.
Listen, man. You put a hosta buffet in front of me, I'll eat it. It's just my nature. But I ain't taking no stinking clue. What do those taste like anyway?
Mr. Deer, what do you have to say?
I'm not saying
anything until I talk to my lawyer.
Yeah. We may be different species, but we ain't no snitches. We hang together.
I'm ready to sing now. To be clear, that little mean. Sing! I'll confess. You with me?
Yeah. See us rustling the leaves. We're the shadow that spits across the field.
We live in the open, underneath the same big sky. But sometimes, just sleep on your porch.
Humans walk by, knowing we love. We're only testing if you think you're free.
We hear all a part of this lush community. But the truth is, your car is in our way.
We are the squirrels, the deer and fox.
And rabbits.
We eat your plants about in front of cars and you can't stop it.
Sounds like cold, tastes like hot, and goes with cornbread. Sounds like chili to me.
Chili supper, woman's club.
Ernie, you just trapped chili all over the room.
Yuck.
Aha! There's our suspect. Look at that knife.
Betsy, how big did you say to cut the cornbread pieces?
Here.
Okay.
What, pray tell, is this?
I knew there was something fishy going on here.
Must be left over from Yom Kippur.
Kipper, this ain't Yom Kippur. Don't get distracted. This is nothing but a red herring.
Very funny. Oh! Ha! Clearly, this is a fencing operation. Look at all of these goods, and I'll bet this is only the tip of the iceberg. Captain Clueless, handcuffs please. Captain Obvious, we will need yours too. I would say these two are the ringleaders.
Inspector, you are about to interrupt the preparation from the world famous chili supper from the women's club.
And these socks and canned goods here, those are collected by the women's club to give to people who need them.
Well, we weren't brought here to catch fencers anyway. Let us get back to the murder investigation.
Inspector, it's not a murder investigation, it's a quest.
Wait, what's with this envelope?
Oh gosh, it looks like it might be another riddle. I can travel so far, it's not power I lack, but here's the ticket. I must stay on track.
I got it, a train.
I hear music.
I wouldn't exactly call that music. Maybe they're just warming up.
It's coming from the gazebo, but it's not time for Oktoberfest.
And it's not time for the Baroque breakfast.
If it's not broken, why do they call it the Broke Breakfast?
It looks like a musical duo.
Maybe they're practicing for the holiday show.
What holiday show? I thought we'd given that up. Talk about retro. Is that an accordion?
Jerry! What's that? I asked for an 8-foot.
This is what they gave me.
8 inches?
Neskedahayashan.
Escadahayashan. When the temple had been cleansed, sanctified and purified, then the miracle occurred, down through the ages glorified.
Escadahayashan.
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 Oh,
Hanukkah, time meant for swinging.
Neskedahayashan.
Every day the dreidel is spinning around. Every voice is lifted in Hanukkah sound.
Neskedahayashan.
Remind us of Hanukkah, each candle light makes a glorious one to recall the heroes of yore.
When the temple had been cleansed, sanctified and purified, then the miracles are come down.
I suppose if we were having a holiday show, which we're not, they would be great.
Okay, so we know how we got here from this riddle. Emitting sounds of notes discordant, I have a roof within a forest.
Obviously, that's the gazebo.
Oh, okay, all right, we have another clue. See, that's my property directed to me, but not where I be. Excuse my delivery. What do you think?
It's easy. Post what? Office.
The post office. Great. Let's go.
I know from experience that suspects will often try to flee when they think we're closing in on them.
But Inspector, we are not looking for a suspect.
There he goes! I told you he was suspicious. This proves it. He is trying to escape. Well, he had better think twice about that.
Now, Inspector, you can see that he's clearly not a suspect.
He's not trying to escape. See, Inspector, when people leave Washington Grove, they always come back.
Especially for the holidays.
I can relate to that.
Home for the Holidays is such a good Christmas song.
It sure is. That was wonderful. There are a lot of great Christmas songs, but seem to be so few good Hanukkah songs.
You know, I was just thinking the same thing.
We need to come up with a Hanukkah song for the holiday show.
Why? It's always the same thing. If I have to hear dreidel, dreidel, dreidel one more time, it's gonna be my top that spins clean off.
Yeah, but so many great Christmas songs have been made by Jewish composers.
You're right. White Christmas was Irving Berlin. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire and the Christmas song Rommel Tourmé.
Maybe that's the key.
What?
Instead of composing an original Hanukkah song, we can, you know, make a Hanukkah hit using hit songs from other artists.
Okay, but if we do this, we're gonna have to do this right. And what do you have for us today?
Hanukkah, mom's latkes, light the menorah, not one day but eight.
Next.
First I was enslaved by those feral guys.
No, no, no. That's the wrong holiday. That's Passover.
And I think we already have enough songs for that holiday.
Absolutely.
Next!
Light it, look, light it, light it, look, light it, light it, look, light it, light it. Light it like a funky menorah. Hanukkah. 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 Don't want to be in shtetls. Just want to spin
like
the dreidels.
One. And here's the next riddle. The trespasser whose warmth is shown can make a home more a home. Could this all be leading us to a house in the grove? Could it be that obvious?
Here's our suspect. And he's about to burglarize the house.
Thanks, Ernie, for coming out to fix my steps.
Boy, Betsy, you took quite a fall.
Yeah, the fruitcake holding them up finally gave way.
Inspector, there's another thing you need to understand about the Grove.
We help each other.
Washington Grove cares.
Just watch.
Drive me out so slow.
flag from Summer in the Parks.
Cool. And I found town meeting minutes. Sorry.
Our clue said we should go to the post office, but we're at the town council.
Town hall. Same difference.
Aha! There's our suspect, and he's about to clobber somebody with that thing.
Who are they?
And why do they have handcuffs?
Where did they come from?
They're from Philly.
They are Inspector Clouseau, Inspector Clunes, and Inspector Obvious.
I have to admit that I hired them to help us out, but they really haven't been much help at all.
You hired them? Where did you get the money?
Through cake sales.
Well, I have seen a lot of foundation work going on in town.
Yeah, and Ernie didn't want to kill anyone with the zoning regulations. They're just deathly boring.
Inspector, there is another thing you need to know. We have committees, we have volunteers, the mayor, the council, and they all work for free.
For free?
Just listen.
We have this bustling town, but that's not happenstance. Those fairs, events, programs, and shows get planned long in advance. Folks play the gracious host, then stay late to clean up. And even though they all work so hard, they don't get paid a buck. The projects that we manage need lots of hands on deck. And so when I'm in charge of one, I beg. Join my committee tonight. Join my committee tonight. People, if you wondered how all this gets done, then join my committee tonight. Come be my volunteer. You'll plan, write, and schlep things all year. I know you love this town and want to make it sparkle. Take on this unpaid career. You don't need any prior experience. Just need to care and raise your hand. You'd be surprised what times, what a teamwork can do when being engaged is your brand. Please get that to me, and soon there's plenty around here to do.
Finding an inward library.
Come make a difference. The real show is behind the curtain. Join my committee. Please, someone help me.
From a Methodist camp to a town full of friends, go to the start to get to the end.
Everyone in the grove?
Everywhere in the grove showed the quintessential grove spirit.
I told you guys Grove Clue would be hokey.
And I told you we should have played the game with chocolate.
They say
The virus that keeps us apart hasn't yet gone away. We try to make do with our masks and our Zooms, but it doesn't feel right.
Don't be sad. One day we will gather in close like we did years ago. I know we're going mad, but even despite years of hardship, we're the Grove.
We'll be back. You can see what the thrill of a lasher will be. We'll be back in town hall, where we'll sing and dance and laugh.
It's been rough, but we're here. We put on this show to bring you cheer.
So if you're down or lost hope, we will make ourselves look really silly to remind you where the Grove. Da 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 da. It's sad that we've been virtual all these years. We're no tech geniuses, that much is clear. But we're a town of action, so though we do not act tons, just say lights, camera, action, and we will give you action together with pleasure. Whatever the weather will weather, we'll be back like before. We'll be here to hear the live crowd roar. We will meet and you'll see we're a special little community, small in size, not in heart. Social distance can't keep us apart, because we will always know we're the town within a forest. We're the spirit of the Grove. Da 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 da. Everybody! Da 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 da. Da 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 da.
Have you been good little animals?
Yes!
Good, here are your presents.
Thank you.
Thank you, Santa.
Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas.